All right, I titled this video Flat Earth Killed Dr. Blair. I'm not making fun of suffering, but just to make a point, because it marks the ending of an era of, unfortunately, delusion, because Delbert Blair was the proponent of, especially out of the conscious speakers, of the whole universal galactic extraterrestrial paradigm, which I subscribe to for my whole 20s. I mean, we fell in love with it. It's amazing. It's entertaining. It's romantic. It's interesting, and it gives you hope. It puts a lot of hope in the future, especially for people who thought they got out of religion and they could look to other solar systems and galaxies and other beings and in the future, aliens landing and interterrestrial communities and all this stuff, which we all fell for, because this universal lie, at least as far as a universal scale, it's at least half a century old as far as, you know, we're talking about other solar systems and galaxies, which that lie comes from the heliocentric lie, which is 500 years old in the Western world, and even in the world in general, because I've read holy texts in the East who subscribe to the heliocentric globular model. We're talking about even the guys in the temples believing in the solar systems and galaxies. So the people who put out this heliocentric lie, they have a lot of influence, and they're hidden, but the influence is just so deep. So I say it killed Dr. Blair. I'm just trying to make light, because if you think about it, I don't know if Blair ran across Flat Earth before he passed, but I could imagine what that would do to him, or to that mindset who spent the whole lifetime in metaphysics based off the universe, which is a freaking lie. It's a fucking lie. And a lot of people base their spirituality off of it. It's a lie. It's still going on. I know a lot of people haven't came across Flat Earth yet, so I'm not, because there was a time even, last year, I didn't know. But I know with my journey, I always had questions even up until a week before I found out. I was still questioning, well, how is everybody standing upright? That just doesn't make sense. How could we live on a ball? Or like when you see those scenes on Star Trek or Star Wars or Stargate, when they fly into the planet, let's say they're flying into the southern hemisphere of the planet, and they will say there's no up and down, but clearly there is an up and down. So if they're flying into the planet, say the southern hemisphere, at what point does it flip and turn upside right side up? It doesn't make sense. It defies natural law, natural experience, because it's a lie. And we still accepted it because of the, there's a hidden power. They just have a lot of influence around the media. There's globes everywhere. And it takes a lot of audacity or genetic skepticism to really say that you know for a fact that that's a lie, or just to not believe it at all. So to find out the whole universe that you've been holding on to since a child, that toy that they gave us to play with, is a lie, is so heartbreaking that, metaphorically speaking, it killed Dr. Blair. So I ran across a conscious video posted about Flat Earth. This was on Black Magic. Brother Rich had an interview, and this guy was so unlearned in Flat Earth theory that it was just nonsensical. And I think we have to come to a conclusion on this. And the conclusion is the Earth is flat, because that's what the ancients said. The Egyptians, the Chinese, the Sumerians, the Babylonians, the Aztecs. Anywhere you go, and everything that you know minus education tells you the Earth is flat. We have to ditch the lie. You can't be a truth seeker going forward in this generation and cling to the globe once you hear about or visit Flat Earth Theory, I mean, to re-subscribe to Globe Theory when being reintroduced to it as an adult is really some foolishness. So, I think this is a very, this is actually the most important topic within consciousness is flat earth. Because everything is, your whole, whatever system you subscribe to is based on your cosmology or cosmography. Every system has a cosmology, cosmography. And of course, when we look back to all the ancients, they always talk about the stars, the sun, and the moon. They don't say the stars are other suns and other galaxies. They don't say the sun is the center, but the moon orbits the earth. No, they speak of the sun and the moon equally because they are equal. They are the same size and have equal significance. The sun gives off cold light. The moon gives off cold light. The sun gives off warm light, hot light. And the stars are just stars in the firmament. So that has a big effect on your belief system. And this is why it's hard for people to let it go. Because a lot of people just say, it doesn't matter anyway. But like I said, it does matter. That's why people get upset. It definitely matters. So, I mean, we definitely need to come to some kind of conclusion on this within the conscious community. I seen Brother Panic, and he's one of the more honest, open-minded researchers. He's pretty much open to it, I noticed. I know he still does classes and everything, so there's a lot going on. But this is something we can't stay on the fence about. We really got to get rid of this globe model stuff. It's really, I mean, once you understand the flat earth physics and everything, that globe looks so ignorant. I mean, and you really start, whenever I hear people talk about it or just reference it and they reference other galaxies, you just like, oh, you cringe because it's like, wow. Even people who think they're aware, you haven't even awakened to the biggest lie yet. And the biggest lie is the globe and the universe. Because like I said, there's no vacuum. We're basically, you can look at it as we're in an egg. We're in sort of like an egg that sits within these dark waters, these cosmic ocean, these primordial waters. So, and there's said to be plenty of eggs. It's not the only egg. But the egg we're in, I think all the eggs would basically be composed of planes. We're on a gross, dense plane called Earth. But we've been fooled by camera tricks and authorities to believe that we're on a ball in the middle of a vacuum full of hot stars with ball worlds circling them. And the limits, which they have no limit because we're told that there's just so many of these balls is everywhere. And it's just they're trying to play on the minds of the masses to get them to feel more insignificant. But, you know, did it work? Possibly. I mean, it does influence the way people behave, I think, subtly. But it is there because how you see yourself affects the way you react and behave. But I'm not a utopian. I don't think flat earth is going to bring utopia because, like I said, everybody, for 99% of history, people have understood that the earth was flat. And we didn't live in utopia just because the earth was flat. So that's some naivety I'm hearing, too, from adults. You have adults thinking that if adults and adolescents figure out we're on a flat earth, somehow this is going to bring peace. That's naive as hell. No, it doesn't work like that because you're still dealing with humans. And that's why I'm a proponent of gnosis. So people know, you need to know the reality of the human condition, period. Never been perfect. Never. We're not going to change human nature because the earth is flat. But I think as far as learners and seekers, and just for general people and who want to know, period, it is very important still to know the cosmography. So it is upsetting to let go. But trust me, we're not spinning on no axis. We're not spinning around a sun. We're not spinning around a galaxy. All that stuff's made up, CGI, and it's computer art, computer graphics, given to us by the authorities. So Flat Earth, I think, killed Dr. Blair. And this is a new day where we let go of all that. Everything has to be rebuilt. I always say go back to the, I mentioned the ancients. There's studies, you get into Hermes. Hermes was all, his whole philosophy is based off Flat Earth. Gnosticism, Taoism. The inner teachings of Taoism, Buddhists, the Vedas, the Hindus, they all speak of Flat Earth. So all this knowledge is more applicable, and I say get rid of all this New Age consciousness. Yes, your mind does influence your reality. That's still true. And I would suppose that quantum physics is still relatively true, just not in the holographic universal sense. This is still a hologram, but not like we were thinking. I still think it's a hologram, though. So I'm still pondering those type of things. But yeah, you do create your reality within the limits of nature, of course. But we're still confined to this plane. And as the Gnostics say, we're in a sort of aquarium. We are, because we're within the waters. There's waters above and below this cosmic egg. Which makes more sense than to say there's this vacuum. We're just sitting in this vacuum held in place by gravity. That lie. So, yeah. Basically, I would just focus on some of the more ancient wisdom now, which makes perfect sense within the light of Flat Earth, and get away from all this New Age consciousness and all this hope in the future stuff. Because it's not going down, not on this plane. So everybody needs to get their mind right and just accept this Flat Earth truth and move on and see what comes of it. I know it definitely had an impact on my studies. Everything just got so much deeper and more real and more serious. Because before I was kind of when we got this heliocentric stuff, it kind of makes us look back upon all the ancient wisdom as, they didn't really know what we know now. And we get a little cocky, and that's unfortunate. It's pretty embarrassing, too, when you realize you were being fooled the whole time. And they did know what they were talking about, and we didn't know what we were talking about. You know, with all these tricks and deception we've been fed, and we just believed. Just going about daily life. So that's why I say Flat Earth, you know, must have shocked someone like Dr. Blair or someone in that mindset. So we got to let it go. Let's move on and see what comes of it with the Flat Earth revelation. Peace. Fun of suffering. But just to make a point, because it marks the ending of an era of unfortunately delusion, because Delbert Blair was the proponent of, especially out of the conscious speakers, of the whole universal galactic extraterrestrial paradigm, which I subscribe to for my whole 20s. I mean, we fell in love with it. It's amazing. It's entertaining. It's romantic. It's interesting. And it gives you hope. It puts a lot of hope in the future, especially for people who thought they got out of religion and they could look to other solar systems and galaxies and other beings and in the future, aliens landing and interterrestrial communities and all this stuff. Which we all fell for, because this universal lie, at least as far as a universal scale, it's at least half a century old, as far as, you know, we're talking about other solar systems and galaxies, which that lie comes from the heliocentric lie, which is 500 years old in the Western world, and even in the world in general, because I've read holy text in the East who subscribe to the heliocentric globular model. We're talking about even the guys in the temples believing in the solar systems and galaxies. So the people who put out this heliocentric lie, they have a lot of influence. And so, and they're hidden. But the influence is just so deep. So I say it killed Dr. Blair. I'm just trying to make light because if you think about it, I don't know if Blair ran across flat Earth before he passed, but I could imagine what that would do to him or to that mindset who spent the whole lifetime in metaphysics based off the universe, which is a freaking lie. It's a fucking lie. And a lot of people base their spirituality off of it. It's a lie. It's still going on. I know a lot of people haven't came across flat Earth yet, so I'm not. Because there was a time, even, you know, last year, I didn't know. But I know with my journey, I always had questions even up until a week before I found out. I was still questioning, well, how is everybody standing upright? That just doesn't make sense. How could we live on a ball? Or like when you see those scenes on Star Trek, or Star Wars, or Stargate, when they fly cosmography. So it is upsetting to let go. But trust me, we're not spinning on no axis. We're not spinning around a sun. We're not spinning around a galaxy. All that stuff's made up. CGI, and it's computer art, computer graphics given to us by the authorities. So flat Earth, I think, killed Dr. Blair. And this is a new day where we let go of all that. Everything has to be rebuilt. I always say go back to the, I mentioned the ancients. There's studies, you get into Hermes. Hermes was all, his whole philosophy is based off flat Earth. Gnosticism, Taoism, the inner teachings of Taoism, Buddhists, the Vedas, the Hindus, they all speak of flat Earth. So all this knowledge is more applicable, and I say get rid of all this new age consciousness. Yes, your mind does influence your reality. That's still true. And I would suppose that quantum physics is still relatively true, just not in the holographic universal sense. This is still a hologram, but not like we were thinking. I still think it's a hologram, though. So I'm still pondering those type of things. But yeah, you do create your reality within the limits of nature, of course, but we're still confined to this plane. And as the Gnostics say, we're in a sort of aquarium. We are, because we're within the waters. There's waters above and below this cosmic egg, which makes more sense than to say there's this vacuum. We're just sitting in this vacuum held in place by gravity. That lie. So, yeah, basically, I would just focus on some of the more ancient wisdom now, which makes perfect sense within the light of flat Earth, and get away from all this new age consciousness and all this hope in the future stuff, because it's not going down, not on this plane. So everybody needs to get their mind right and just accept this flat Earth truth and move on and see what comes of it. I know it definitely had an impact on my studies. Everything just got so much deeper and more real and more serious. Because before I was kind of, when we got this heliocentric stuff, it kind of makes us look best. As far as the universal scale, it's at least half a century old as far as, you know, we're talking about other solar systems and galaxies, which that lie comes from the heliocentric lie, which is 500 years old in the Western world and even in the world in general, because I've read holy texts in the East who subscribe to the heliocentric globular model. We're talking about even the guys in the temples believing in the solar systems and galaxies. So the people who put out this heliocentric lie, they have a lot of influence, and they're hidden, but the influence is just so deep. So I say it killed Dr. Blair. I'm just trying to make light, because if you think about it, I don't know if Blair ran across flat Earth before he passed, but I could imagine what that would do to him, or to that mindset who spent the whole lifetime in metaphysics based off the universe, which is a freaking lie. It's a fucking lie. And a lot of people base their spirituality off of it. It's a lie. It's still going on. I know a lot of people haven't came across flat Earth yet, so I'm not. Because there was a time, even, last year, I didn't know. But with my journey, I always had questions, even up until a week before I found out. I was still questioning, well, how is everybody standing upright? That just doesn't make sense. How could we live on a ball? Or, like, when you see those scenes on Star Trek, or Star Wars, or Stargate, when they fly into the planet. Let's say they're flying into the southern hemisphere of the planet. And they would say there's no up and down, but clearly there is an up and down. So if they're flying into the planet, say the southern hemisphere, at what point does it flip and turn upside right side up? It doesn't make sense. It defies natural law, natural experience, because it's a lie. And we still accepted it because of the, there's a hidden power. They just have a lot of influence around the media. There's globes everywhere. And it takes a lot of audacity or genetic skepticism to really say that you know for a fact that that's a lie, or just to not believe it at all. So to find out the whole universe that you've been holding on to since a child, that toy that they gave us to play with is a lie, is so heartbreaking that, metaphorically speaking, it killed Dr. Blair. So I ran across a conscious video posted about Flat Earth. This was on Black Magic.